My name's Hazel Edwards and I'm an author, and one of my books that I'd like to share with you today is There's a Hippopotamus on Our Roof Eating Cake. Now, this book is illustrated by Deborah Narland and it's published by Penguin. And I actually still live in the same house that had the drip on the roof, or under the roof, which gave the idea for this particular story when my then 3-year-old son said that was the hippo up on the roof that ate cake. And so sometimes an idea can travel a long way, and this book's now gone into lots of different languages like Chinese, and it's a film and it's been staged and so on. And there's a particular pleasure in that in a book, but really the book belongs to the reader, not the writer. And so the reader needs to look at the clues that are in the pictures and the words and read it together. And I think that's one of the joys for a family. So I'd like to share this one with you. Our roof leaks, drip, drip, drip. My daddy says there's a hole in our roof. I know why there's a hole. There's a hippopotamus on our roof eating cake. He can do what he likes. Drip, drip, drip. My hippopotamus doesn't like baths. He's having a shower. I know, because I heard him. There's a hippopotamus on our roof having a shower. One little girl who read this book said to me, I know why they've got drips. It's the shower. The shower's dripping. And that's what I mean, that a book actually belongs to the reader once it's been published. Mummy's on a diet. She eats lettuce, tomato and cheese. My big brother eats peanut butter sandwiches. I eat honey sandwiches. My hippopotamus on our roof eats cake all the time. Now, when my children and the neighbour's child helped me with the writing of this story, we actually had Vegemite, but Vegemite is a brand name, so it was changed to peanut butter. And the mum looks a little bit like the illustrator Deborah Narland. Mummy asked about the cake. Is it birthday cake? No. Is it chocolate cake? Is it special cake? Yes. There's a hippopotamus on our roof eating special cake. Now, the special cake means that it's whatever thing, whatever type of cake you imagine for yourself. So one child might think of it as a cake of soap or fish cake. Somebody else might think of it as an ice cream cake. And all of those things are okay because the word clue is special. Yesterday, I fell over and cut my knee. It hurt. There was a lot of blood. At the hospital, the doctor put 3 stitches in my knee. I cried. Last night, the hippopotamus told me something. He's got a sore knee too. There's a hippopotamus on our roof with a bandage on his knee. Now, the original version of the story had a band-aid, and a band-aid looks more ridiculous because it's even smaller than a bandage, but that's a brand name too, so we had to make it into a bandage. There's a hippopotamus on our roof watching television. You might have a chat in your family about what sort of television a hippopotamus, what sort of programs a hippopotamus might watch. Some of the suggestions have been he might watch the swimming in the Olympic Games because he's a good swimmer. He might like MasterChef or the cookery programs. You ever think what sort of programs he might like to watch? He's very big. He can do what he likes. Mummy won't let me watch television. After dinner and a story, I have to go to bed. My hippopotamus watches. I know he does. There's a hippopotamus on our roof watching television. Today I was naughty. I drew on Daddy's best book. Daddy growled at me. Down here, no one's my friend. My hippopotamus lives on the roof. He's my friend, I know. And this is the importance of the reassurance of this book, of having an imaginary friend who always supports you. He isn't cross. No one growls at him. He's too big. He can draw anything. There's a hippopotamus on our roof drawing with crayons. A And that is not graffiti. He's drawing pictures, not graffiti. And originally they were texters, and we made them into crayons. He wasn't there last night. I know why. He told me he went to work. And this is where, again, you can have a discussion about where you think the hippopotamus might work. A lot of people come up with different ideas. But some things, he might work at the zoo. My hippopotamus works part-time at the zoo. Zoo visitors look at the animals. At the zoo, he watches people. When he's not working, my hippopotamus eats cake on our roof. And that's a very important page, this one, and one you might spend a little bit more time on. Another person who helps make a book is a book designer. And the book designer has to decide where things will go on the page. And with this, these two pages are very well designed because your eye goes to the middle of the page, so the people are looking at the hippo and the hippo is looking at the people. But if these pages were turned transposed, put on the other side, you'd have one eye going out here and one eye going out there, and it wouldn't work. So a really well-designed picture book, your eye will go to the middle of the page. So that one works quite well. There's a hippopotamus on our roof riding a bike. I've got a bike. Mummy won't let me ride on the road. There are cars on the road, there are no cars on the roof. He can ride anywhere. I know he can. There's a hippopotamus on our roof riding a bike. Now, this book was written over 30 years ago. I'm really old. And so at that time they didn't have to have compulsory helmets for bikes, but they do these days. So if we were redrawing this, we would have to imagine that the hippo had a bike helmet on as well, which would probably be a sensible thing to do. The men fixed the roof today. Bang, bang, bang. No more drips. They didn't see my hippopotamus. He climbed down the ladder while the men had lunch. He'll be back tonight. Then I did say, there's a hippopotamus on our roof eating cake. Now, there are some other books about the hippopotamus, about going to school and going to hospital and places where children might feel a little bit apprehensive. So it's a really good way of sharing the story and be able to talk about some of those issues, about having a new baby in a family or having a birthday or going on holidays. And so this is the first and probably the most well-known of all of them. There's a hippopotamus on our roof eating cake. And this was even given as a present to Princess Mary of Denmark for one of her children. So the story has travelled. It's gone into Chinese recently. So sometimes you never know where a story might end up, especially one that starts with a drip from the roof.